We are here at Fagradalsfjall volcano. It's the 6th of July 2023, and the reason why we're here is because there has been a lot of shaking going on. Earthquakes, seismic activity, and now scientists are wondering if it's going to erupt again. I'm Ragga, and I'm the co-founder of Lava Show, and Lava Ambassador, as I like to call myself. And I have always been extremely fascinated with volcanoes, geology, and lava. And basically, what we are now looking at is that there may be yet another eruption on the horizon. And what's interesting about that is that Iceland is one of the most volcanically active places on Earth. And the reason for this is actually twofold. First of all, we have basically the Mid-Atlantic Ridge that splits Iceland into two parts. And as it is, the ridges are basically pulling the country in opposite directions. And this makes room for magma to actually travel towards the surface. So that's one reason. The other reason is because Iceland happens to be right on top of a very massive mantle plume. And this mantle plume, or hot spot as it's sometimes referred to, actually is pushing magma constantly up to the surface. So these two things are the reasons why Iceland is one of the most volcanically active places on Earth. If you're interested in this thing, I would like to point out that we have this book on display in the Grapevine store, and you can go and order it now if you like. Right where we're standing now, this is actually probably about a 1,000-year-old lava field. And then right next to us, there's a lava field that is 1 year old. And the contrast is obvious. I mean, here we have the lava, we have the beautiful moss all over, and it's like seemingly just smooth and like stones. But as you can see, the new lava, it's completely black, it's very rough, and it's absolutely not safe to walk on. Be mindful of that. And just see how rough it is. It's still, like, it's not warm feeling, so I wouldn't burn myself if I touch it, but I would absolutely advise against actually walking on it. There can be holes, and there can be dangers looming underneath. But what's really interesting about this, the eruption last year, for those of you, if we should remind ourselves a little bit how it worked. So back in 2021, there was a series of earthquakes that took place for about 3 weeks. And it was a very concentrated seismic period where there was thousands of earthquakes indicating that magma was rising towards the surface. And that's exactly what happened. And then the fissure opened up and the magma came up and now the lava started flowing. But then, about 6 months later, that eruption stopped. And then, for about a year, everything was quiet. Until last year, 2022, in August, when suddenly, for a brief amount of time, there was a lot of seismic activity again, earthquakes were taking place, and a few days later, the crater over there opened up and this lava field started coming out. It was a small eruption, so it was actually safe to walk up to the area and just explore at the wonders that is nature. It was absolutely fantastic. And now what we're seeing is that the seismic activity has started again. Fagradalsfjall, which had actually been dormant and sleeping for 6,000 years, has definitely come back to life, that's for sure. A little bit farther in the distance, on the slope there, you can actually see that there's lava from the 2021 eruption that was flowing down that slope. And actually right over there on the mountain top, you can see the very top of the biggest crater. So what is basically happening is that the first eruption was happening the farthest away from us. The eruption last year then took place a little bit closer. But now what we're looking at is actually that the sort of most concentration of the earthquakes that we're seeing is actually happening between where the lava flowed last year and the mountain that we see there in the distance called Keilir. So most of the seismic activity that's been going on has been somewhere on that line. So speculation basically is that if it will erupt again, it may happen somewhere in this area. So let me actually explain what's going on. So we are in the Reykjanes Peninsula, and we are actually in an area where there's no magma chambers. So what basically is going on is that when magma is traveling up to the surface, it's coming straight from the mantle. And what basically happens is that the magma is traveling up and creating something that we call a magma intrusion, or a dike, if you will. And it's actually very distinctive in shape. So what happens in this magma intrusion is that it's very, very, very thin, but it goes miles and miles, both lateral and vertical. And it's a little bit like this paper. So basically what we have is inside of the crust, we have basically an area that looks a little bit like this. That's just magma. And then that's where all the seismic activity is happening. And then at some point, the magma may actually breach the surface and travel all the way up, and lava will start pouring over the surface again. And this is where it might happen, right here, somewhere between the previous lava field and Keilir. Quite exciting. So even if you don't necessarily see a lot of people here right now, the area actually is open. But there is a level of uncertainty, and that basically means that the authorities have warned that an eruption may take place at any given time. So there's definitely a risk factor. And therefore, if you really do want to come here, you absolutely can, but you just have to pay attention to risk factors and be really mindful of how to react, around volcanic eruptions. And the thing is, the reason why the authorities have actually kept the area open is because they basically trust the Icelandic people to be the judge of how to behave around an eruption site. And that's why, you know, it could be a good idea to pay attention to the locals.
We in civil protection in Iceland, we are all about safety. We recommend people not to be at the area right now because we really don't know what is going to happen. We think the eruption will be at the area at any time now. So please do not go there. It is not safe. It is not forbidden to walk at the area, but we really recommend not to do it. One of the reasons it's dangerous to be there is the gas. So if you're there, you can smell the gas. So if you can, please try to go away, walk away, and go as high as you can.
When I was younger, I was raised with a lot of stories about volcanoes and eruptions, and particularly how they basically affected the people living in Iceland. And that's always been an aspect that's fascinated me. And so as I grew older, every chance there was to go to an eruption site and just see this kind of spectacle firsthand, I took. And so, you know, back in 2010, my husband and I, we actually went to the eruption site at Fimvörðuháls. Oh, it was amazing. It was so incredible. There was a lava fall. So just exchange lava with what, like water with lava, and you get what I mean. And it sparked the idea to actually create a show where people would be able to experience real flowing lava in a safe environment. So that's actually what we did. We founded a company. We opened up Lava Show first in Vík on the south coast, and then in Reykjavík. And we there have a show where you get to experience real lava in a completely safe environment, and you get to learn a lot about how, you know, the history of Icelandic volcanism. It's a very educational show and very connected to the culture. So what a day. It's been amazing, and thank you all for staying with us. We are quite excited about the development, and we hope you are too. Whatever will happen, we will definitely report on it. So don't miss anything. Stay tuned. Oh, wow. Did you feel that one?